Let me also inform our viewers that the Election Commission press conference is all set to begin. And let's hear in what dates they have to offer.
In charge of administration and planning, Commissioner, all my colleagues from the Exhibition and all the colleagues from India. As you are aware, the 5-year term of the 16th Lok Sabha is due to expire on 3rd June 2019. Article 324 of the Constitution bestows the relevant powers, duties, and also the functions of the Election Commission. While Section 14 of the Constitution of People Act 51 provides for conduct of elections to constitute a new Lok Sabha before the expiry of its current term. Taking into account these constitutional legal provisions, various judicial pronouncements on issues, the Election Commission of India has
made, in fact, attempted a very comprehensive preparation for the conduct of election to the 17th Lok Sabha in a manner that is free, fair, inclusive, accessible, ethical, participatory, and also festive. When independent India held its first general and assembly elections during 51-2, not everybody was convinced of our capacity to successfully conduct the exercise. In fact, democracies in the world, then numbering maybe around 40, most of them were very skeptical. But India, by conducting our elections, emerged as a, should I say, beacon light for the emerging democracies all over the world. The scale and complexity of the elections has only grown since then. The population of India increased 3.3 times between 91 and 2001 census. But there are other statistics also which have gone up sharply, as expected. Mahatma Gandhi said, democracy must, in essence, mean the art and science of mobilizing the entire physical, economic, and spiritual resources of all the various sections of people in the service of the common good of all. Keeping all this in view, this commission started preparing for elections for quite some time. We started with organizing a series of meetings with chief electoral officers of all the states and UTs in order to review various aspects of election preparedness. Video conferences with the chief secretaries, DGs, home secretaries, chief electoral officers and police nodal officers from MHA and as well as from the states were held on 21st, 22nd and 28th January to assess the overall law and order situation, state or UT specific areas of concern, and deliberate on the quantum of central armed police forces required. Several rounds of discussions were held with the Ministry of Home Affairs at the level of our officers, and we also had an in-depth discussion with the Union Home Secretary and his team. The Commission also held deliberations with several key departments, especially railways, in order to ensure smooth movement and facilitation during the conduct of elections. To get a first-hand knowledge of the status of poll preparedness in the states, we visited several states and UTs to review the poll preparedness. During these visits, there is a standard SOP which is followed by the Commission, and not just us, but before us also. This has been a tradition that first of all we start with interaction with the political parties. After that, we have the presentations by the CEO of the state, the police nodal officer of that state, and the central nodal officer from whichever CPF is designated for that state or UT. After that, we have a fairly in-depth interaction lasting maybe sometimes 10 to 12 hours, if not more, with the collectors, SPs, IGs, commissioners of police, wherever there is commissioner system, and all their colleagues. This is followed by a meeting with the central government regulatory departments, income tax, state excise, central excise, in order to talk about the expenditure monitoring. Then there is a meeting with the chief secretary, home secretary, and their colleagues, DGP and their colleagues. After doing all this, we report back to the media in a press conference in the state. And same process was followed this time also. While finalizing poll dates, examination schedules of various state boards, CBSE, other relevant factors like various festivals, including festivals which have religious kind of bindings, for example, when people are fasting, etc. Harvest season in certain parts of the country, as well as the inputs obtained from the weather department, are also adequately factored in. In fact, behind the scenes, I would like to tell you that our colleagues, the senior deputy commissioner and all his colleagues, they have been slogging for maybe months together to work out all these things. They do every time, they have done this time also. The commission firmly believes that the purity of electoral roll is the foundation of credible elections. We have been constantly monitoring the health of the rolls in the country, and after the introduction of Aeronet, now we have a pan-India monitoring systems here in Delhi. The electoral rolls have been revised with reference to 1/1/2019 as qualifying date. Process of continuous updation shall continue till the last date of filing nominations. Total electorate in the final published roll would be in the vicinity of 900 million compared to 814.5 in 2014. This marks an increase of 84.3 million voters since 2014. There are 15 million voters in the age group of 18 to 19. 38,325 third gender others, 71,735 overseas electors, service electors more than 1.6 million, 99.36 electors have EPIC cards, 23 states and UTs have 100% EPIC coverage. The commission continues to try the maximum coverage of EPIC still. In this direction, some major initiatives were taken. VVIP voter verification and information program launched to aid voters in checking their names in the rolls. Toll-free 1950 for checking names through SMS. Special camps organized for enrollment of eligible voters who are left out. No suo motu deletion of names after final publication of electoral roll is permitted. No deletion modification after 10 days of announcement of elections without prior approval of the commission. Official voter slips, including those in braille, for our voters for persons with disability voters. This is distributed or shall be distributed at least 5 days before the poll to all enrolled voters. This process is rigorously monitored and schedule of distribution shared with the public representatives. In fact, at every stage, all these things are shared with the public representatives. However, we would like to make it clear that photo voter slip issued at the last minute shall be used for guidance, but not as a proof of identity in the polling stations. We have already given a very detailed ad 2-3 days back that that slip will not be the proof of identity, but there are 11 other options which can be used to cast your vote, provided, of course, the name is on the electoral roll. A voter's guide in vernacular English is being handed over in these elections to every household, giving all relevant information. On the ballot unit below the name of the last candidate, there will be a button for nota option for the voters who do not wish to vote for any of the candidates. And as an additional measure to eliminate confusion in the minds of our voters, where you press the button in front of that, there's a photograph of the candidate also, so that you make a more conscious choice seeing the photograph of the candidate for whom you want to vote. Voter assistant booths will be set up at every polling station to extend facilitation to the voters. There are approximately 10 lakh polling stations this year as compared to 9 lakh in 2014, an increase of 10.1%. Why I have used the word approximately is that in some special circumstances, for example, exigencies of weather, snowfall, etc., with the permission of the commission, a new or auxiliary polling station can be opened even at the last minute. Of course, before the elections. Assured minimum polling facilities at all polling stations like drinking water, electricity, shade, toilets, ramps, and a standard voting compartment are being provided. And these are monitored very closely by the commission in the meeting with the collectors, video conferences, and the meeting with the chief secretary. Efforts are also being made to make voting comfortable, accessible, and sensitive, particularly to the needs of senior citizens, persons with disability, and ladies. VVPATs will be used with EVM at all polling stations in this election. Adequate number of both have been made available for smooth conduct of elections. The ballot units already reached the destination as per requirement, 23.3 lakhs. The control unit, 16.35 lakhs, and VVPATs, 17.4 lakhs. This also includes, by the way, reserve units, because as per the SOP, for example, if the control unit starts malfunctioning, then entire thing is changed. But if the VVPAT malfunctions, VVPAT is changed, something like that. And these are details. So accordingly, the requirement as well as the reserves have been worked out. The Commission has specified elaborate standard operating procedures for EVMs and VVPATs, including FLC, mock poll, two-stage randomization, mandatory VVPAT slip count in one randomly selected polling station per assembly segment. There are very stringent security and administrative protocols related to the machines, including their storage movement, usage, as well as handling reserve and VVPATs. In fact, after these four or five anecdotal incidents of the last five poll-gone states, new, fresh SOPs have been issued for making the last mile transportation, even of the reserve EVMs, very, very stringent and rigid, including the putting of monitoring by GPS, etc. The Commission has laid a lot of emphasis on widespread demonstration and awareness activities at the assembly as well as booth level in order to familiarize as many voters as possible with EVM and VVPATs. Consequent on the schedule of announcement of general elections through the press note, the MCC for the guidance of political parties and candidates comes into effect from today itself in the entire country. The Commission calls upon political parties and candidates to strictly adhere to the same. Elaborate arrangements have been made to ensure effective implementation of the MCC, and any violation, will be dealt with in the strictest manner. All the candidates are required to file an affidavit in Form 26 along with their nomination papers, which includes information on their criminal antecedents, if any, assets, liabilities and educational qualifications. As all of you are aware, recently all the proposals of the Commission regarding the expansion of and revealing more information, including of HUF, was accepted by the Ministry of Law, and accordingly the Form 26 has been already revised and circulated all over. This format was amended on 26 February 2019. Non-filling of this affidavit in the prescribed format, which also now includes giving you a PAN number, if you have, will result in rejection of nomination paper. Candidates with criminal antecedents would be required to furnish information in this regard in the local newspapers and TV channels on 3 occasions during campaign period. Elaborate arrangements have been made to ensure peaceful conduct of elections. In order to curb noise pollution and prevent disturbance to the people at large, usage of loudspeakers is prohibited at night between 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. No loudspeakers permitted at all during the period of 48 hours ending with the hour fixed for conclusion of poll in the polling area. Commission has also directed political parties, candidates, agents to desist from using environmentally hazardous publicity materials and promote usage of eco-friendly substances for preparation of election campaign material. This is a new effort by the Commission, but this is kind of appeal to everybody to use this. CAPF, Central Police Forces, are going to be deployed in large numbers, the numbers can't be discussed, to ensure free and fair elections well in advance for area domination, especially in areas which are very, very sensitive, route marches and patrolling to enhance confidence and reassure the voters. Targeted deployment of central forces in all expenditure-sensitive constituencies all over the country. They will also undertake special confidence-building measures through route patrolling and route marches in order to bolster especially the confidence of weaker sections of the society, weaker and more vulnerable sections of the society. Preventive measures are being taken by the district magistrates and police authorities to maintain law and order. Commission lays equal emphasis on sufficient deployment of video cameras, CCTVs and webcasting, especially at the critical and vulnerable polling booths. All critical events shall be videographed. Commission appoints sufficient number of general observers, police observers, expenditure observers, awareness observers and micro observers to closely monitor various stages of the election process. Control rooms and complaint monitoring systems are set up with 24 hours toll-free numbers. In fact, on the issue of central observers, this time Commission has taken a conscious decision that wherever required, in those states or UTs which are expenditure sensitive and wherever there are major security issues, we would be sending special observers of sufficient seniority and experience and standing and stature to these places. I will not be able to name the states because that's not something which kind of in advance label state like this, but we have all the information and we'll act accordingly. We also now have, by now, thanks to our IT and ICT wings, stringent monitoring of all critical events of the poll day using the state-of-art IT applications. This includes This is an C-Vigil, which is an Android app which helps citizens to record any violation of model code of conduct on the mobile and promptly send to election authorities for option. By the way, this was started on a trial basis during Karnataka elections in Bangalore under the direct supervision of the commission and extended subsequently to all these five polygon states. In these five polygon states, almost 28,000 such complaints were received. A citizen can give his or her name and number, and the authority on the other end is duty-bound, no options, to report back within 100 minutes the action being taken, proposed to be taken, etc. If a particular complainant feels vulnerable or is making a complaint about, say, last cash transaction happening somewhere and doesn't want his or her name to be revealed, in that case, the commission will get it published in the local newspapers so that he or she becomes aware of the action taken and her privacy also protected. This is a major, major tool of citizen empowerment. And it is really the experience of these five polygon states. We are really hopeful that now when it is used pan-India, it will kind of add another dimension to the empowerment of our citizens. We also have started a PWD app for persons with disability for registration, modification, as well as to ask for doorstep facilities and wheelchair on the day of poll. We already have introduced and we kind of monitored very closely that all the permissions can be obtained on Suvidha candidate app for, and they can also track their status. Samadhan is an integrated web portal for registering and resolving citizen information, suggestions, feedbacks and complaints. This is another way of getting the feedback. As you are aware, the commission for many years under one of its former CECs had started systematic voters education and electoral participation, that called SWEEP. This program is basically for dissemination, advocacy and communication. And for this, comprehensive measures are undertaken for enhancing our contact with the voters and increasing their participation in this largest festival of democracy, Desh Ka Mahatyohar. This is being personally monitored by the steered and monitored at the level of bureaucracy in the commission by senior DC, administration and planning, and his other colleagues, and commission itself takes very regular account of this. Comprehensive measures are also being taken to reach out to the voters in the remotest corners through folk art festivals, local festivals, Nukkad Nataks, and this time also we've started extensive use of community radio, and we are also embarking on the area of how to kind of, besides the print and electronic media, how to kind of enlarge our outreach through social media. The commission has always considered engagement, considered media as an important ally and a potent force multiplier in ensuring an effective and efficient election management. Hence, the commission has directed all CEOs of the poll-going states to have positive and progressive engagement and interaction with the media. Commission also requests the media to play a positive, proactive and constructive role in supplementing and facilitating our efforts towards delivery of free and fair elections. The media certification and monitoring committees have already been constituted at all the states and districts to deal with the problem of paid news and other media-related violations and pre-certification of political advertisements on electronic media. An additional member, a social domain media expert, is included now in the membership of the MCMC, this BDS Education and Monitoring Committee at the state and district level, so as to get inputs from his or her side. Candidates are required to furnish details of their social media account. All political advertisement on social media will also require pre certification. All expenditure on campaigning advertisement on social media is to be included in the election expenditure account. All provisions of model code of conduct shall also apply to the content being posted on social media by candidates and political parties. And based on the recommendations made by the committee appointed by the commission regarding the further enlargement of section 126 of RPA in sync with the new media and deliberations made with the various other stakeholders, social media platforms, the major steps are as follows. The intermediaries, viz. Facebook, Twitter, Google and YouTube have committed in writing to ensure that any political advertisement published on their platforms will be certified from MCMC. Some IT applications are also being thought of to streamline it further and make the process less cumbersome. In fact, Commission has taken a stock of the IT applications being developed by our team, and maybe we'll introduce as a pilot project in some states to start with. Google and FB have also announced verification of political advertisers and ad archives with reference to advertisement buying. Social media platforms have committed to implement pre-certification, as I said earlier. To keep a check on election violations and menace of fake news and hate speech during the election period, social media platforms have told us that they have appointed dedicated grievance officers to take necessary and prompt action against the contents published on their platforms. Social media platforms have committed to take action on any content reported by designated officers of ECI also, which violates various electoral laws. Internet and Mobile Association of India, in consultation with IAS, with ECI, is formulating a set of code of ethics for intermediary online platforms. This is a work in progress. Now I will start reading what you all have been waiting for. Hindi bhi aati hai aur Hindi ka version aapko milega jab aapko press note milega. English ke saath saath Hindi ka bhi milega. English ke saath saath Hindi ka bhi milega. Hindi us Hindustani sab aate hain aisi baat hai. Anyway, I'll read out the proposed phase one. Before that, I would like to inform all of you that this time, instead of 9 phases, we have 7 phases of election. Phase one, date of issue of gazette notification. Notification hone ke gazette notification hone ka din. 18/3/2019, Monday. Phase one, last date of nomination, aakhri tarikh nomination ki, 25/3/2019, Monday. Last date of nominations, 25/3/2019, Monday. Date for scrutiny of nominations, 26/3/2019, Tuesday. Last date for withdrawal of candidature, 28/3/2019, Thursday. Date of poll, first phase, 11/3/2019, Thursday. Date of counting, 23/3/2019, Thursday. 23rd May 2019. Or date before election shall be completed, 27th May 2019. Phase 2, date of issue of gazette notification, 19th March. Last day of nomination, 25th March. 26th March. Date for scrutiny of nomination, 27th March. Last date of withdrawal, 29th March. Date of poll, 18th April. Date of counting, same, 23rd May. Phase 3. Date of issue of notification, 28th March. Last day of nomination, 4th April. Date of scrutiny, 5th April. Last date of withdrawal of candidature, 8th April. Date of counting, of course, 23rd. Date of poll, 18th April. No, we are sending you all this by, after I have read it through, you are getting it all by soft copy, almost right away. I'll read out the phase 2 again. Okay. No, I'll read out the phase 2 again because he's asked for it.
Sir, hello.
Phase 3, okay. Thank you. Phase 3. Phase 3, date of issue of gazette notification, 28th March. Last date, we'll come to that after this. We'll come to that after this. That is the second statement. Last date of nomination, 24th April. Phase 3. Date of scrutiny, 5th April. Last date for withdrawal of candidature, 8th April. Date of counting, 23rd May. Date of counting. Date of poll, 23rd April. Phase 4. 23rd April. 23rd April. Is it clear now? Phase 4. Date of issue of notification, 2nd April. In fact, the most important are two dates that I can give you instead of giving you seven dates. The date of poll, 29th April. And date of counting, same. Phase 5. Date of issue of gazette notification, 10th April. Date of poll, 6th May. Phase 6. Date of issue of gazette notification, 16th April. Date of poll, 12th May. Phase 7. Date of issue of gazette notification, 22nd April. Date of poll, 19th May. And all... Sorry? I'll repeat the date of poll. First phase, 11th April. Second phase, 18th April. Third phase, 23rd April. Fourth phase, 29th April. Fifth phase, 6th May. Sixth phase, 12th May. Phase 7, 19th May. Am I clear now? And all countings, without no need to say, but I am repeating, 23rd May. Now the Lok Sabha state-wise details if you want. Or otherwise, I'll just tell you that in phase 1, there are total 543 constituencies, as you are all aware. Phase 1 is 91. In 20 states, phase 1 is 91 in 20 states. Phase 2 is 97 in 13 states. Phase 1 is 91 constituencies in 20 states. Is it clear? Phase 2 is 97 constituencies in 13 states. Is it clear? Phase 3 is 115 constituencies in 14 states. When I say states here, it also means states and UTs. Phase 4 is 71 constituencies in 9 states. 71 constituencies in 9 states. Phase 5 is 51 constituencies in 7 states. Phase 6 is 59 constituencies in 7 states. Phase 7 is 59 constituencies in 8 states. You want me to read it out once more? Phase 1, 91 constituencies, 20 states. Phase 2, 97 constituencies, 13 states. Phase 3, 115 constituencies, 14 states. Phase 4, 71 constituencies, 9 states. Phase 5, 51 constituencies, 7 states. Phase 6, 59 constituencies, 7 states. And phase 7, 59 constituencies, 8 states. The notification, the formal notification of by-elections in all the seats, etc., is being made separately today itself. Jammu Kashmir. States going in single phase. Andhra, Arunachal. Before now reading further, it must be clear that they'll be overlapping. Same state would be named maybe in 2 phases or 3 phases. But still I'm reading. I start reading now. States going in single phase. Andhra, Arunachal, Goa, Gujarat. Andhra, Arunachal, Goa, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Kerala, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Punjab, Sikkim, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Tamil Nadu. Uttarakhand, Andaman Nicobar, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu, all right, you have waited for so long, I'll repeat. Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Uttarakhand, or you want me to repeat from the beginning? Andaman Nicobar, Dadra Nagar Haveli, Daman and Diu, Lakshadweep, Delhi, Pondicherry, Chandigarh. In all 22 states going in single phase. States undergoing 2 phases. Karnataka, Karnataka, Manipur, Rajasthan, Tripura. States undergoing 3 phases. Assam, Chhattisgarh. States undergoing 4 phases. Jharkhand. Third phase, Assam, Chhattisgarh. 3 phases. 4 phases, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha. Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha. 5 phases, Jammu Kashmir. 6th phase, no state. 7th phase, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal. Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal. And now I'll read out once more. 1st phase, 22 states and UTs. 2nd phase, 4 states and UTs. 2 phases, 4 states. 3 phases, 2 states. 4 phases, 4 states. 5 phases, 1 state. 7th phase, three states. You see, the issue also is that there has to be ensured the movement of the CPFs from one place to the other, and they go by trains, etc., and then they require some time for initial settling down, which is how all this has been done.
Now
which Jammu Kashmir.
Before that, sir, each state and each, which are the states
and the date
state of polling.
So we have it.
No, yes, please.
Sorry?
Please read the date.
To you. Sir, it's being sent to you now.
No, what are the...
Just
now. Sir, seven faces states.
That's the most important basic information.
Nobody knows.
Like, Andhra is going to be on which date?
Phase one, Andhra, all the 25 seats. Phase one, 11th April, it has been said 4 or 5 times, I'll say it again, 11th April, 25. Now I'll read state-wise, please. Andhra, first, now I'm reading phase one, right? 11th April, Andhra, 25, Arunachal, 2, Assam, 5, Bihar, 4, Andhra, 25, Arunachal, 2, Assam, 5, Bihar, 4, Chhattisgarh, 1, Jammu Kashmir, 2, Maharashtra, 7, Manipur, 1, Meghalaya, 2, Mizoram, 1, Nagaland, 1, Odisha, 4, Sikkim, 1, Telangana, 17, Tripura, 1, Uttar Pradesh, 8, Uttarakhand, 5, West Bengal, 2, Andaman Nicobar, 1, Lakshadweep, 1, total 91. Am I clear now? Phase 2, Assam, 5, as said earlier, phase 2 starts from 18th April, Assam, 5, Bihar, 5, Chhattisgarh, 3, Jammu Kashmir, 2, Karnataka, 14, Maharashtra, 10, Manipur, 1, Odisha, 5, Tamil Nadu, 39, Tripura, 1, Uttar Pradesh, 8, West Bengal, 3, Puducherry, 1, total 97. Phase 3, starting from 23rd April, Assam, 4, Bihar, 5, Chhattisgarh, 7, Gujarat, 26, Goa, 2, Jammu Kashmir, 1, Karnataka, 14, Kerala, 20, Maharashtra, 14, Odisha, 6, UP, Uttar Pradesh, 10. West Bengal, 5. Dadra and Nagar Haveli, 1. Daman and Diu, 1. Total 115 spanning 14 states and UTs. Phase 4 starting 29th April. Bihar, 5. Jammu Kashmir, 1. Jharkhand, 3. Madhya Pradesh, 6. Maharashtra, 17. Odisha, 6. Rajasthan, 13. Uttar Pradesh, 13. West Bengal, 5. 8. 5 was phase 3. 71 across 9 states. Phase 6. Phase 5, Bihar. 6th May. Bihar, 5. Jammu Kashmir, 2. Jharkhand, 4. Madhya Pradesh, 7. Rajasthan, 12. Uttar Pradesh, 14. West Bengal, 7. Total 51. Phase 6 starting 12th May. Bihar 8. Haryana 10. Jharkhand 4. Madhya Pradesh 8. Uttar Pradesh 14. West Bengal 8. National Capital Territory of Delhi 7. Phase 7 starting 19th May. Total phase 6 59. Phase 7 starting 19th May, Chhattisgarh 8, Bihar, I stand corrected, Jharkhand 3, Madhya Pradesh 8, Rajasthan 13, Punjab 13, not Rajasthan. Rajasthan is over already. Punjab 13. West Bengal 9. Chandigarh 1. And UP 13. Himachal 4. Total 59. This is the states.
Sir, what about the
Assembly separately notification being issued.
Sir, what about the Tamil Nadu states? 21 assembly seats are lying vacant. Do you have any decision have been taken?
Decision has been taken and is being announced to the media.
We'll take the questions. When we
issue you the soft copy, in that each constituency will also be mentioned. Okay. Jammu Kashmir. After holding holding elections in Jammu Kashmir, the commission has been continuously assessing the prevailing situation in the state, requirement of central forces and other logistics for elections, requirement of the security for the candidates, and preparedness of the state for the election on key factors, including the recent developments. The Commission had conducted several rounds of review meetings with State Administration of Jammu Kashmir, with MHA, including Home Secretary and his team. State Government of Jammu Kashmir and the Union Home Ministry had sent detailed and specific inputs to the Commission regarding holding elections in the state. In fact, we had sought the comments from the MHA quite early to assess the situation and level of preparedness. Commission had recently visited J&K and had detailed meetings with all the political parties, important central and state agencies, district authorities, Chief Secretary, DGP, and others. Based on all these inputs and recommendations from the states, state government, Home Ministry, political parties, other stakeholders, constraint of availability of central forces and other logistics, requirement of security forces for security of candidates in wake of the recent incidents of violence in the past, recent past, and keeping all other challenges in mind and taking a totality of views, the Commission has decided at this stage to announce only schedule of the parliament elections in Jammu Kashmir. The Commission will be regularly and on real-time basis monitoring the situation in Jammu Kashmir and continue to take inputs from all necessary quarters, and decision-taking holding legislative assemblies in Jammu Kashmir will be taken soon. The Commission has also decided for more effective monitoring to appoint 3 special observers for Jammu Kashmir. Shri Noor Muhammad, IAS of 77 batch retired, IFS IAS 77 batch retired. Shri A.S. Gill, IPS 72 batch, who retired as DG, CRPF, and also served as IG in Jammu Kashmir, in CRPF, in charge of Jammu Kashmir from 95 to 97. Shri Vinod Jutshi, 82 batch, who has served in the Election Commission for almost 6 to 7 years, and I think most of you know him as it is. Shri Noor Muhammadji has occupied various positions like Secretary, National Disaster Management Authority, Member Secretary, NCR Planning Board, Chief Electoral Advisor, UNDP Kabul, International Election Commissioner, Afghanistan in the 2005 Parliament elections, Deputy Election Commissioner of India, and Chief Electoral Officer, Uttar Pradesh, amongst with other assignments. And Shri Gill, as I said, retired as DG CRPF. He remained DGP in Rajasthan, and he also was in Jammu Kashmir as IG CRPF from 95 to 97. Shri Zutsi, he retired as Secretary Tourism, Government of India, and he remained in the Election Commission for a little over 7 years. These observers have been contacted by the Commission. They have kindly consented, and a meeting is scheduled by the Commission at 4 o'clock in the afternoon to go over the various modalities with the 3 honorable central observers.
Sir, just one confusion, sir.
Can I just finish? Yes. I'll just take. As far as the other. The Commission has also taken into account the fact that the tenure of legislative assemblies of states of Andhra Pradesh, Arunachal, Odisha and Sikkim will expire on 18th June, 1st June, 11th June and 27th May. I repeat, Andhra 18th June, Arunachal 1st June, Odisha 11th June, Sikkim 27th May. After taking into account all these relevant factors, the Commission has decided to hold elections for these assembly legislative assemblies for these four states simultaneously with the general elections to the 17th Lok Sabha. Elections to the different assembly constituencies in states of in these states will follow the same schedule as for the corresponding parliamentary constituencies, that answers your question, of which these are relevant assembly segments. There are 34 casual vacancies, by elections as we call it, in the legislative assemblies of 12 states as on 9th March 2019. The Commission has decided to hold by-elections to these 34 assembly constituencies following the same schedule as per the relevant parliamentary constituencies already read out to all of you. On the occasion of 17th Lok Sabha election, the Commission reassures the nation, all the stakeholders, of its solemn resolve and deep commitment to fulfill its constitutional mandate to conduct free, fair, credible and ethical elections. Commission appeals to the 11 million plus election machinery, directs the 11 million plus election machinery to rededicate themselves to the tasks associated with the conduct of elections as a sacred duty, as they have been doing election after election. Commission appeals to all the stakeholders, and in particularly the political parties, the candidates, to uphold the democratic traditions of the nation by maintaining high standards of political discourse and fair play in course of the election campaigns. Commission also sends an appeal to all the voters to reinforce the democratic ethos of the nation by turning up at polling stations and exercise their right to vote in an informed and ethical manner, because the voters are the ultimate sovereigns in the democracy. Now I will take questions.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Let's go one by one. I'll take from the left front row first.
Yeah. I'll before you start, you see, if we seven people raise hands, nobody will be able to listen. Let Shefaliji point out one after the other.
And I'll begin row wise. I'll first begin with first row, first left side.
I'm on your right, on your left, front row. I'm George Kalivaril from Deepika Malayalam Daily. So my question is regarding VVPATs. You know, there was huge demand for VVPAT counting from various political parties and candidates. But somehow ECI never allowed counting of the VVPATs. And now, will you be at least counting VVPATs at least in the half or wherever candidates or political parties demand?
You see, the political parties have given us a memorandum to this effect. I will not hatch behind the fact that the matter is already pending before the Honorable Supreme Court. Let me just finish, please. I will take 2 minutes to answer this. The Commission has started counting one VVPAT per assembly constituency. And now when the political parties and other stakeholders started raising the issue of counting more VVPATs, the Commission has appointed a high-powered committee of Indian Statistical Institute who are already looking into it. The commission expects the report to come anytime, certainly before the poll process is over. And the commission will then discuss the report within the commission and take a view, which will then be a kind of mentioned all of you by us.
Sir, Suchitra here from Newsnet in Tamil. Sir, what about the Tamil Nadu bipoll elections? So, will it not be conducted?
Yes, they will be conducted.
Along with all
bipolls, I repeat, all bipolls as pending on 9th March shall be conducted with the elections to the...
Sir, Gujarat mein bhi bipoll hai aur 5 seaton pe.
When I said all bipoles, I mean all bipoles.
Sir, Santosh.
Please hold on. I'll just take it to right side, Santosh.
Sir, mere do questions hain. Ek question ye hai ki...
She has asked him, let me come to you.
Sir. One by one.
You
have just announced that. I have read it 4-5 times.
To set in 9th March.
Please
what is
hold
the
on. Right sir, now, if you carry on like this, we will not be able to take any questions then.
Sir, Santosh from Lokmat newspaper. Here, sir. Sir, I have two questions. एक सर ये कि पिछले चुनाव में और अभी विधानसभा चुनावों में देखा गया सभी लोगों के पास आजकल मोबाइल है आपने बाकी फैसिलिटी दी है मतदान केंद्रों पे लेकिन मोबाइल जमा कराने की फैसिलिटी नहीं है तो क्या इस बारी होंगी और दूसरा सवाल है सर कि ये जो साइलेंट पीरियड है 48 आवर्स का सोशल मीडिया पे उसकी निगरानी कैसे होगी आप सेंट्रलाइज करेंगे या स्टेट वाइज होगा या डिस्ट्रिक्ट वाइज होगा
आई विल टेक यू सॉरी लेट मी नो मोबाइल का जरा क्वेश्चन रिपीट करिए
सर मोबाइल का क्वेश्चन ये था कि अब सभी के पास मोबाइल है लोग मतदान केंद्रों पे जाते हैं मोबाइल लेकर लेकिन आपने बाकी सुविधाएं दी है मोबाइल जमा कराने की सुविधा वहां नहीं होती है जिससे
वी विल ट्राई टू डू समथिंग अबाउट इट
थैंक यू एंड सर सेकंड क्वेश्चन द साइलेंट पीरियड
ही हैज आस्क्ड टू क्वेश्चंस
या द सेकंड क्वेश्चन इज द अबाउट साइलेंट पीरियड हाउ यू विल मॉनिटर सोशल मीडिया ड्यूरिंग द साइलेंट पीरियड
आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू
अलाउ नहीं करेंगे ना देख नहीं रहे
नैरेटिव
किसी को अलाउ नहीं कर रहे
नो वन सेकंड
अपने सवाल सर पूछ रहे हैं तो जवाब सुन लिए अगर अभी भी ना बोले प्लीज
फिनिश दिस आंसर फर्स्ट ऑन द सोशल मीडिया इन माय मेन स्टेटमेंट आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन अ डिटेल्ड नैरेटिव एंड आई हैव आल्सो सेड दैट सर्टेन थिंग्स आर वर्क इन मोशन इन एडिशन देयर इज अनदर मैटर गोइंग ऑन इन द ऑनरेबल बॉम्बे हाई कोर्ट which is listed in the very near future. So keeping all these things in view and through our MCMCs and the undertaking, the quantum of undertaking given by some of the social media platforms by themselves in writing through their associations, we will try and monitor it.
To the right, Neeraj here.
Sir, state ke bipoll, state assemblies ke jo bipoll hai sir, uska date ek baar aur bata diye.
सर
आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही
सर मैं
सर तब तक इधर से
सर दिस इज स्वाति चंद्रशेखर फ्रॉम TV5
जस्ट टू मिनट लेट्स वाली पॉइंट आउट लेट हर पॉइंट आउट
सर लेट्स स्वाति चंद्रशेखर फ्रॉम TV5
हेलो
अनंतनाग में चुनाव नहीं हुआ दूसरा सवाल यह है कि हाल के जितने भी लोकसभा चुनाव हुए पिछले 3-4 बार में उसमें कभी भी उड़ीसा में 4 फेज नहीं रखा गया तो दो सवाल है कि आप उपचुनाव नहीं करा पाए लोकसभा चुनाव करा रहे विधानसभा नहीं जम्मू कश्मीर में और दूसरा यह कि उड़ीसा में 4 फेज क्यों है
मैं आपके दोनों प्रश्नों का एक एक करके उत्तर देता हूँ आई रिप्लाई वन बाय वन अबाउट जम्मू अबाउट उड़ीसा As I told you, we have kind of, if you have seen this pattern closely, or if you study it more closely, we have tried to cover left-wing affected areas of various states at one go. That is the pattern. And in that pattern, whichever states fall, because once the left-wing affected states get covered, which require heavy, much more force, then those forces can move to other areas. And there is no particular, the timing of elections, as I said, as I read in the very beginning, depends on several factors, in fact, a combination of factors, and most important being the availability of central forces, the timing when they are available, and the time taken for their movement from one place to the other and settling down for area domination.
Your follow-up question about
Jammu Kashmir. I'm sorry. Jammu Kashmir, one second. That second part is not finished. Jammu Kashmir, we have, even aapne Anantnag ka specific question pucha. By the way, Anantnag ek parliamentary constituency mein, jab maine abhi padh ke sunaya, to keval ek parliamentary constituency mein, teen phase mein election ho raha hai. Three phases. Aur Jammu Kashmir ke political parties bhi chahti hain chunav hona. Maine to pehle jab wahan se hum aaye the tab bhi hum logon ne press mein share kiya tha. Lekin at the same time jab political parties ne baat baar baar ye bhi kahi saath jab milne aaye jo baat humne zyada nahi kahi ke hamari security ka kya hoga, hamari security ka kya hoga. Aur I cannot reveal how many people are put with one assembly candidate, but the number is sizable because they have to put people, security people, with the candidate at his residence or at his or her office. And therefore, keeping the totality of things in view, or Jammu Kashmir se chuke ab forces kuch, rather, we've got some Naxalite area ki is tarah se systematic planning karne se, और जम्मू कश्मीर में हमारे हमने तीन तीन ऑब्जर्वर एक स्टेट के लिए इस लेवल के भेज रहे हैं ताकि वो सिचुएशन में कुछ भी परिवर्तन आए आधारभूत सिचुएशन में वो उनकी निगाहों से कमीशन व्यू लेके जम्मू कश्मीर का चुनाव कराएगा
सर बात के बाइपोल का डेट क्या है
सर मैं अनु चक्रवर्ती
सर स्वाति चंद्रशेखर फ्रॉम टीवी5 सर व्हाई टू फेसेस फॉर कर्नाटका बिफोर आल्सो देयर हैज बीन ओनली वन फेस फॉर कर्नाटका बट दिस टाइम व्हाई टू फेसेस फॉर कर्नाटका हियर टू योर टुवर्ड्स योर राइट द थर्ड रो एंड माय सेकंड क्वेश्चन इज हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू कर्ब the publishing of political parties in social media because it's not only the political parties that's going to publish news or advertisements in social media, it's also going to be from the general public. And my first question is, why two faces for Karnataka? Because even before there has been only for 28 constituencies, what is the logic behind this when for Tamil Nadu it is 39 constituencies in one face, but 28 constituencies of Karnataka for two faces?
She has asked three questions. Okay. आपने तीन
याद हो जाए.
स्पीच आती है जो फेक अकाउंट्स उसमें होते हैं उसको लेकर इलेक्शन कमीशन इन लोगों से किस लेवल पर बात करेगा और दूसरा मेरा एक छोटा सा सवाल कि मुस्लिम वोटों के ध्रुवीकरण को लेकर जो राजनीतिक दल बार बार प्रयास करते हैं उसको लेकर इलेक्शन कमीशन की क्या एक्शन रहेगी क्योंकि मुस्लिम मतदाता इस देश की बहुत सारी सीटों पर निर्णायक भूमिका में होते हैं थैंक यू
अब आपके दोनों क्वेश्चन कंबाइन कर देता हूं एक एक करके जवाब देता हूँ कर्नाटका आई कांट टेक फाइव क्वेश्चन एट वंस आई विल कम टू यू आफ्टर दिस
जस्ट होल्ड ऑन प्लीज लेट हिम रिस्पॉन्ड प्लीज
देयर इज आई हैव बीन सेइंग एंड आई एम रिपीटिंग वेरी हम्बली बट वेरी फर्मली दैट द फेजिंग ऑफ इलेक्शंस डिपेंड्स ऑन द मूवमेंट ऑफ अवेलेबिलिटी ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एंड मूवमेंट ऑफ फोर्सेस सो देयर इज नो डिजाइन बिहाइंड holding it in one, for example, in Rajasthan, last time you had two phases, although there were only 25 seats, and in two phases, there were only five districts which had one phase. This time the state government, the state official machinery, in their meeting, they repeatedly said that in addition to those five sensitive districts, three, four districts have become more sensitive. So now we have added those. Tomorrow you will say that why last time it was five districts and now five constituencies and now 12 constituencies. There's no, I mean, now on the social media front, if they did not appear before the parliamentary standing committee as reported in the media, it is for the honorable standing committee to take action, not for me to comment. Not for the EC to comment on that.
Sir, mera sawal hai poster ko lekar kal jis tarah se ek khabar aayi ki poster mein sena ke jawanon ki tasveer istemal ki ja rahi hai uske baad ek statement jari hua mera sawal ye hai ki kya is tarah ka koi statement ke bawajood agar koi neta ya fir koi jo candidate agar is tarah ka cheez istemal karta hai to uske khilaf kya karwai ki jayegi chunav aayog ki taraf se
sir ek sawal aur saath mein sir idhar
one second sir answer away one second please media. Now we have combined five questions almost. Let me give you answers one by one. Karnataka, I have replied to you.
सवाल का जवाब नहीं मिला है मुस्लिम वोटों के ध्रुवीकरण और मैंने आपसे पूछा था कि स्टैंडिंग कमेटी
मैंने कहा कि फाइव क्वेश्चन आप लोगों ने पूछे लेट मी रिप्लाई वन बाय वन
सर
उसके बाद फिर सिक्स सेवन एट नाइन टेन तक जाएंगे ना
और सर एफबी और गूगल आपकी बात नहीं सुनेगा तो आप क्या करेंगे मेरा सवाल ये था आपसे
सॉरी
यदि एफबी गूगल व्हाट्सएप ट्विटर आपकी बात भी नहीं सुनेंगे तो इलेक्शन कमीशन क्या करेगा ये विदेशी कंपनियां हैं सर उनका सीईओ आपकी स्टैंडिंग कमेटी के सामने नहीं आया आप सम्मन करेंगे और वो नहीं आए तो आप क्या एक्शन लेंगे ये मेरा सवाल है
देखिए लेट्स टेक टू थिंग्स वन इज द लॉ एट द मोमेंट राइट नाउ इफ यू प्लीज लिसन टू मी फॉर टू थ्री मिनट्स आई विल रिप्लाई टू ईच पॉइंट टू द बेस्ट ऑफ माई एबिलिटी राइट One is the law at the moment. This section 126 at the moment doesn't apply to print media. At the moment doesn't apply to social media. That is the law. And for that a committee was appointed. That committee gave its report 2-3 months back and they have recommended certain things. I cannot give every, in that committee they have recommended certain things. They have also used the word other entities, which means social media. That proposal has been sent to the Ministry of Law because it involves amendment in the rules. And we are trying our best if this amendment can come through. As soon as possible because that doesn't have to go to parliament. It is something within the ministry itself. Am I clear on the legal position? Now, the other thing. Now let me finish this.
Let me finish.
You already asked,
please.
We started sir, with you. Sir, so let us finish this.
Sanjay Sharma, aaj tak se.
Zara, ruk jaiye, unhe complete karne dijiye, we'll come back to you.
I said I am answering five questions one by one. Finish them. I'll not get up till I answer each of every. We'll not get up till we answer each and every question.
Sir, bhav samajh mein aa gaya uska.
Sanjay Sharma, aaj tak se sir.
Sir, in past we've seen.
Aisa kahiye, aap log pehle baatchit kar lijiye.
Can sir finish and then we ask the next question, please?
Okay. क्या अगला सवाल पूछ सकता हूँ मैं?
नहीं, right now नहीं. Let him first complete first. Can we quieten down, can listen to what sir has to say before we move on to the next question?
Sir, ab tak to sirf sena ki vardiyon ko lekar baat ho rahi hai, sena ka istemal to chunav mein hota hai, sena ki vardiyon ka istemal ho raha hai, log sena ki vardi pehen ke stage par chunavi rally mein ja rahe hain, kya aachar sanghita mein wo cheez under mein aati hai aur aap uske khilaf karwai karenge?
Chalo pehle aap hi ke prashn ka uttar de dete hain. Aaj se 2 din pehle इवन हमारे एक फॉर्मर नेवल चीफ ने भी एक पत्र लिखा था जो ऑलरेडी मीडिया के संज्ञान में है वी गॉट इट एग्जामिन लीगली इमीडिएटली वी ऑलरेडी हैव अ प्रोविजन विच वॉज यस्टरडे नाइट मोस्ट ऑफ यू शुड हैव गॉट इट we have formally reiterated those instructions as a part of MCC to the general secretaries of all the political parties, national or state. And that instruction is coming into force now from as we are speaking and talking to each other. I will request my team, I was told that yesterday night these instructions were sent to each and every newspaper, but I will still request my team to tweet it just now to all of you for your perusal. That is a part of MCC that has been reiterated, and in that, in the covering letter itself, it has been mentioned that we will take as strict an action in this as we take for violation of any provision of MCC.
सर एक सवाल
लेकिन सर ये
नाइन धापर से तो सर एक सवाल ये है एक खरीदार से सवाल
इफ देयर इज अ फॉलो अप क्वेश्चन टू दिस अदरवाइज प्लीज जस्ट होल्ड ऑन
यस फॉलो अप क्वेश्चन दिस साइड ऑन सोशल मीडिया इशू सर सर दिस साइड ऑन सोशल मीडिया इशू
लेट अरुणिमा फिनिश हर क्वेश्चन प्लीज
सर ऑन सोशल मीडिया राइट मैम
सर अरुणिमा फ्रॉम सीएनएन
सर एक सवाल इधर से बहुत जरूरी सवाल है और ये सवाल इस हॉल के अंदर का है
मैम
जो सवाल पूछे जा रहे हैं वो हॉल के बाहर के हैं मेरा सवाल आपसे जुड़ा हुआ है मैं अभिषेक उपाध्याय हूँ टीवी नाइन भारतवर्ष से सवाल ये उठ रहा है कि इलेक्शन कमीशन की टाइमिंग पे सवाल उठ रहे हैं कि आप लोग ने संडे के दिन अचानक ये डिक्लेयर कर दिया चुनाव पहले ये था कि चुनाव घोषित होगा एक दो दिन बाद और तमाम पार्टियां आपसे सवाल कर रही हैं आपके इंटेंशन पे सवाल कर रही हैं कि आप इसका स्पष्टीकरण देना चाहेंगे क्योंकि इलेक्शन कमीशन का ये जो अनाउंसमेंट है इस पर सवाल खड़े हो गए हैं अच्छा लगेगा कि अगर आप इसका स्पष्टीकरण दें और हर को जवाब दें जो लोकतंत्र के चुनाव
अगर आप एक एक करके पूछेंगे तो हर सवाल का जवाब देंगे अगर आप सारे मीडिया को आपको सबको आपका संडे आफ्टरनून डिस्टर्ब किया है तो आपके सारे सवालों का जवाब देंगे थोड़ा सा धैर्य से शांति से पूछ ले अच्छा रहेगा
सर मैं धीरे धीरे पूछता हूँ यही सवाल अब आराम से सवाल ये उठा है सर आखिरकार आप लोगों ने चुनाव जो है वो आज क्यों घोषित कर दिया है टाइमिंग पे सवाल उठ रहे हैं
लास्ट इन द लास्ट पार्लियामेंट फॉर एग्जाम्पल लास्ट पार्लियामेंट द लाइफ ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट वॉज अप टू 31st May The life of the parliament was up to 31st May. This time the life of the parliament is up to 3rd June. So if the intentions of election commission are to be doubted and election commission has to account as it should be accounting to the nation for everything, then the life of parliament is 1st, 2nd, 3rd more, 3 days. So if 5th has become a kind of a addict for all the times. If you see that way, last 6 elections, the dates have been announced on different days. Right? But anyway, since 2014 seems to have become today the issue versus 19, so shall I be now saying that last time elections were held in 9 phases and this time we are holding in 7 phases? And 6th, 7th, 8th, any day get accounted for, right? Initially we had thought that we will do it on Monday, but then we realized that why should we give you a holiday, but then we thought okay, we will do it today, and we have done it today.
Sir, on Kashmir, Arunima, I have to ask you this.
See,
sir,
ma'am,
right,
ma'am,
in the, right in the front
related
here.
Question, ma'am.
Yes. The Kashmir election that you gave out seems to be talking about 8 seats because 2 in each phase. There are a total of 6 Lok Sabha constituencies, if I'm not mistaken. Can you just clarify?
Six.
But the way you read out the schedule seems to be counting in 8 states. Can you just clarify that once more, please?
Six,
right? Yes. And the second thing that I have to ask you is that there are political leaders from the valley who are tweeting and asking that even at the peak of terrorism in 90s, assembly elections in Jammu and Kashmir were not postponed. Have you not been assured enough forces by the Union Home Ministry? Has that forced you to take this decision? For the first time since the 1990s, elections are not happening. Assembly elections are getting postponed. Thank you.
You see, central forces is definitely a big issue and you cannot disregard the recent developments. The commission ultimately doesn't capitulate to anybody and will not capitulate to anybody. But at the same time, Commission cannot be non-cognizant of the situations on the ground. And Commission cannot be non-cognizant of what the union or the chief secretary, for that matter, that then you will say that why are we meeting chief secretaries of every state? Because we want to review the situation. The chief secretary, the DGP, and the opinion of the union home secretary, and the availability of forces is definitely because since 96 or 97, in our country, in many states now, the central forces requirement, at least it has not decreased in any state. To put it most politely, it has not decreased in any state. How much it used to be and how much it has increased, this is not for me to divulge or discuss. But at the same time, it has not decreased in any state. By going by your logic, the requirement should have gone down or should have remained static. It's not static. And that is why the very idea of appointing three observers of this standing and caliber are to actually monitor the situation on a real-time basis and try and do the elections as soon as the ground situations allow. And last thing I already said once, but I'll repeat it again. On an average, in an assembly constituency, there could be, let's say, 8 to 10 candidates. So even if you take it 8 or 10, multiplied by 86 assembly constituencies, this is the additional quantum required for their protection. By the way, many candidates of the earlier panchayat elections, you can verify yourself, are still staying much after the elections are over to panchayats and local municipal bodies. They are still staying in guest houses and paid for by the state government. Still, much after these elections are over.
Ashwini to the left.
Sir, on your right. Sir,
Ashwini
sir.
To the left.
Sir, there. Sir, this side. Sir.
Let Ashwini sir, on your right, finish sir. His question
sir,
first.
Side, sir. Sir, on your right,
sir. Ma'am.
Hello, this is Arun.
Sir, on your right, this side.
Nothing is audible, by the way. Just hold on.
आपको मैं थोड़ा सा अगर आप चूंकि आपने बहुत ही अहम सवाल दोबारा किया है तो उसका आई विल रिप्लाई टू यू इन सम डिटेल इफ यू गिव मी टाइम एंड अटेंशन. EVMs are being used in this country for over two decades. Agar aap 2014 bhi le lein, to you have one result in the parliament. Uske baad you have elections 3 months later in Delhi. You have X result in parliament and a Y result in Delhi. After that you have these five polygon states, in between you had elections in Karnataka, Gujarat, parts of Northeast, and you have all kinds of different results. So why have we made EVM some kind of a football that if the result is to the liking of X, EVM is okay, as if EVM is voting? Secondly, by the way, the entire process of the EVM, which was initiated much 80s, the entire day-to-day monitoring of the specific technical monitoring of the EVMs is being done by a highly expert technical committee. One second, please. Now you have asked a very detailed, very vital question. I have to respond to it. And who are there in this committee? Professor Sahni. Who is Professor D.T. Sahni, Professor Emeritus, IIT Delhi. Professor Rajat Mona, Director, IIT Bhilai, former DG CDAC. Professor Dinesh K. Sharma, Professor Emeritus, IIT Mumbai. There's another member now, he's slightly unwell these days. Now this committee, by the way, is functioning since 2010. It has no link with 2014 or 15 or 16. 2010. And Professor Sahni, by the way, was also a member of the earlier committee from 2006 to 10. And these people have done so much research in their own fields. They are authorities. They are the people who are dealing with the all technical quality standard approval of the EVMs. Still, because Commission still started using on its own VVPATs, because there were doubts raised that we want to further kind of strengthen the process. And that process was also started by Commission on its own, but it got a hearty endorsement from the honorable courts also. And there again, it was not originally mandated that you are going to count, but random counting started being done. The randomization is done in front of candidates, in front of the political parties. And that, even then when the questions are being raised, now another committee, expert committee of ISI has been appointed, Statistical Institute, with another expert from Central Statistical Organization, and they will give a report.
Ashwini Fadnis from the left, please.
Hello, sir.
Sir, between this side.
Beach just with... hold on. Let Ashwini finish his question, please.
Sir, hello, sir. Here. Excuse me, sir.
Sir, this case is three rajyas. All seven phases mein chunav.
I am not getting your, because so many people are speaking.
Sir, देश के ऐसे तीन राज्य हैं जिसमें आप all the seven phases में poll conduct कर रहे हैं।
मधुरेन जरा रुक जाएं।
How are you going to control the money power in the forthcoming parliament election?
We have already decided. I am very glad you asked this question. We have already decided that we are going to. I am not. That's why I said. But you are naming the states, so I don't either deny it or accept the name of any state at the moment. But within the commission, we have already decided, which I just announced, I don't know whether you listened to it or not, that we shall also be appointing special expenditure observers for expenditure-sensitive states. And those special expenditure observers would be, say, ex-chairman of CBDT or ex-chairman of CBEC or some retired finance secretary, some retired revenue secretary, like that.
Sir.
Of course, in the next 3-4 days, we have internally prepared a panel for various issues. Jammu Kashmir, I announced today because Jammu Kashmir, one knew that there will be misgivings, so we have announced it right away. But within the next week or so, wherever required, we will start sending the special expenditure observers.
Sir, my question is, what are the regulations for exit poll and opinions poll? Left side of yours, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Sir, what are the regulations for exit polls and opinions polls for the news channels and newspapers?
The same as earlier. No change.
Ashwini, can you please...
Arora, sir, this side. NRI voters ke liye kya suvidha hogi? Kya online voting kar sakenge? Sir, front side.
Sir, is taraf bhi dekhne ke
liye baat rahe hain. NRI voters ke liye.
Excuse me, sir.
Sorry. देखिए मेरी बात सुनिए पक्ष और विपक्ष या आज का पक्ष कल का विपक्ष या कल का विपक्ष आज का पक्ष ये लोग आपस में एक दूसरे के लिए आरोप प्रत्यारोप क्या लगाते हैं या नहीं लगाते हैं ईसीआई उसका संज्ञान उस स्तर तक लेता है जो कि प्रोविजंस मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट में है और मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट में रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा हमारे सीनियर डीसी मिस्टर सिन्हा को कि बाकी सब भेजने के बजाय आजकल में एक मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट का भी लेटेस्ट वर्शन आप सबको भेज दें
एक्सक्यूज मी सर
क्या ये ईसीआई के वेबसाइट पे है
सर एक्सक्यूज मी हियर सर
बिहार में सॉरी आज तक समबडी फ्रॉम आज तक वांटिंग आस्क क्वेश्चन
सर अश्विनी फ्रॉम द हिंदू बिजनेस लाइन सर I just wanted to check with you, there have been allegations by political parties and others that the election commission has pushed the date to the very
I've already answered it Only
answer. Sir,
Sandeep Savarkar.
Elections conduct करवा रहे हैं. तीन राज्यों में आप तीन राज्यों में आप सात चरण में चुनाव करा रहे हैं, जिसमें बिहार भी शामिल है. क्या causes हैं राज्यों में सात चरण में चुनाव कराने के लिए?
उदाहरण के तौर पर अगर बिहार को ही आप लें तो वहाँ क्या नक्सलवाद की समस्या है, आतंकवाद की समस्या है कि आप सेवन फेजेज में तीन राज्यों में आ रहे हैं, वजह है बताएंगे।
और सर इसी से रिलेटेड मेरा आरजेडी के तेजस्वी यादव ने बोला यू आर फेवरिंग द
आप लोग,
दिस इज व्हाई यू हैव सर माय क्वेश्चन फॉर बिहार।
सर माय क्वेश्चन इज,
अब एक आदमी बोलेगा तो
सर मेरा सवाल है कि तीन राज्यों में आप सेवन फेजेज में चुनाव करवा रहे हैं, क्या कारण है इसके? उदाहरण के तौर पे अगर बिहार को लें तो ना नक्सलवाद की समस्या है ना आतंकवाद की, लेकिन सात चरण में चुनाव कराने की आवश्यकता क्यों पड़ी है चुनाव आयोग को?
और सर इसी से रिलेटेड मेरा क्वेश्चन है, द आरजेडी तेजस्वी यादव इज सेइंग दैट यू आर फेवरिंग द रूलिंग पार्टी।
ऑनरेबल एनी ऑनरेबल पॉलिटिकल लीडर इज वेलकम टू से व्हाट ही फील्स लाइक। availability of forces, their movement, their logistics. Only one thing commission kept in mind, which I am again reiterating, but still the question is being asked again and again, maybe you are really, that is that for the left wing affected areas, we tried to do elections across the states so that we could use those forces in other places. There is no other answer to it.
Sir, this side. आपके लेफ्ट में सर, सर मेरा आपसे एक सवाल यह है कि हर साल हमने देखा है कि जब कभी भी चुनाव होते हैं, विधानसभा के चुनाव हो या लोकसभा का चुनाव हो, मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट का बहुत वायोलेशन होता है और सिर्फ एक FIR दर्ज होकर रह जाती है। कोई एग्जाम्पल आज तक सेट नहीं हो पाया कि अगर कोई मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट को तोड़ता है तो उसके ऊपर कोई सख्त कार्रवाई हो, इसके बारे में आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
मैं अभी इस बात पे तो मेरा टिप्पणी देना नहीं बनता कि आज तक कार्रवाई नहीं हुई या नहीं हुई, क्योंकि सभी इलेक्शन कमीशन पे जोर देते हैं, लेकिन कार्रवाई इस बार जब हम रिव्यू पे गए थे स्टेट्स के, जहां जहां हम गए हैं या बाकी सब स्टेट्स से हमने इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑलरेडी मंगवा ली थी कि लास्ट इलेक्शन में जो केसेस हुए MCC वायोलेशन के, उनका आउटकम क्या हुआ, और उसके भी हम फिगर्स ही आपको दे देंगे कि किस किस जगह पे, ऐसा नहीं है कि सारा यूनिफॉर्म आउटकम हुआ, कुछ स्टेट्स ने बहुत अच्छा काम किया, कुछ स्टेट्स में और ज्यादा काम करने की आवश्यकता है, उनको हिदायत दी गई। और मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट का जो इस बार वायोलेशन होगा, मैं ये कहूँ कि पहले से बेहतर होगा। दैट इज नॉट फेयर फॉर मी एंड दैट इज नॉट द राइट थिंग फॉर मी टू से ऑल्सो, बट यस द मॉडल कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट शेल बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड in letter and in spirit. We'll meet again after the elections and talk about it.
Thank you so much. Hello,
sir.
This is Krishna from ABN Andhra Jyoti, sir. This is regarding, sir, this side. Sir, this is Krishna from ABN Andhra Jyoti to your left side, sir. Sir, this is question. There are many cases have been registered against so many people who are using Form 7 to delete names of voters of opposite parties. So there have been so many cases registered who are using this Form 7 illegally. So did you come across to this complaint, and YSRCP and Telugu Desam Party also gave a complaint against to you regarding this data theft also? So one side Andhra Pradesh government is saying that Andhra Pradesh government said this side. Telugu Desam Party saying that their data has been stolen by Telangana government and given it to YSRCP party. So what is your say on this? What election actually, commission is going to do?
Now can I answer to you please? You see, in the five poll gone states also, there were complaints which had come from political parties. Every single case was gone into by sending special teams and verifying down to the last detail. In one state, they had gone against the ECI and the Honorable High Court dismissed the writ because they thought the procedures being followed by ECI are very meticulous. Regarding Andhra and Telangana, in fact, there are two types of complaints. One is a complaint which has come from the YSR party chief against Andhra, and some other parties have also joined. We have already sought, in fact, one delegation came just 2 days back. We have already sought detailed inputs from observers, so from CEOs. And in fact, in two or three places, we have already sent a team outside the ECI, but who have the domain experience of elections to verify these complaints.
Thank you so much. We'll be
Sunil ji, here is Sandeep, sir, from Bartuman newspaper. I have two questions. States mein jo ruling party hai aur jo opposition party hai, jyada tar wo allegation dete hai, jo central force jaate hai, वो स्टेट पुलिस के ऊपर चला जाते हैं, वही डायरेक्शन देते हैं कहाँ जाएंगे, कहाँ ड्यूटीज होंगे, एक। और नंबर टू है, आप बोला कि फेस्टिवल के ऊपर ख्याल रखा जाएगा, बट इन बंगाल देयर आर पोयला बैशाख, बंगाली न्यू ईयर्स डे ऑन 15th अप्रैल, बट इन वेस्ट बंगाल देयर आर 7 phases टोटल, व्हाई?
Phases part I have already replied, I'll not go into again. And I also said, when I mentioned the factors, I mentioned festivals as one of the factors, not the only factor. You see my press statement formally when the copy comes to you. Second thing you asked was about
central force of duties. Duties of central
force.
That
is factually incorrect. That is factually incorrect. Because the deployment of central forces is done in very close supervision of the observers which we send from here. That is factually incorrect.
Thank you. We come to an end of this press conference now. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.